Okay. So now the next topic is, see, I'm going to tell you about the grid. So what is a grid? Okay. So here we have an option called grid here. Show grid. See, this is called grid. Okay. So what we can do with the grid is, see, I can actually do alignments. Means, see, I can place the objects exactly in this on these grids. If you don't see grid, what you can do, see here, go to view and then select this. Okay, see here, go to view, show grid. Okay, and also we'll also activate one more option, that is snap to grid. See, this is very important. Snap to grid, what means, what will happen, whatever object you take, it will actually stick to these lines. See, it will stick to these lines like this. So like this. So what will happen if you do like that? So then it will actually it will be good for alignments. You can get actually perfect alignments. See, like this. Perfect alignments you can get. See. So this is the advantage of grid. So we can properly place, and also the lines here you can see, if you want the lines to be little bit close, okay, if you want close or far away, so you can go to edit and preferences. See, edit, preferences and general, and then what you can do is, here, see, here we have this guides and grid. Okay, so here you can actually increase or decrease the grid line. Here it is in pixels. Okay, so here if you put a different value here, let us say 10. Okay, if you put 10 and then if you just click OK, see, now it is very close. Just look at the lines. So you can again open the guides and grids. And let me put only one. See, now there is the lines are little bit away from each other. So means there is a little bit, they are not close to each other, the lines. Okay, so that is mainly we can use this grid for alignments. Okay. So something like this, okay. And I will also tell you one more thing, how we can use the grid actually. See, we can actually put some images inside the grid actually. See, I'm going to go to file, place, and I will just open one image. So let me open this image. So we'll just keep it in front of this, keep this shape in front of the image. Okay, so just keep it like this, and then we'll shift select both the image and shape, and then right click, make clipping mask. See, so like this I can put a image inside this shape, and I can, if you want to adjust the image, simply double click on it, and then see, I can adjust the image like this. And then I can come back. See, just click here. Now we are out. I will also do again one more time. See, this time I will take one more shape. Okay. And then what you'll do? So what is the next step or next thing we all do? So just I will place one more image. You can do without grid, but you'll not get alignments. So you can just keep it as a friend. Select both the things and right click, make clipping mask. And if you want to adjust the image, double click on it so that you will go inside here. Keep it and then adjust it. Okay, like this. So see here. Okay, so something like this. And we can put one more image. So how to put one more image? See, Shift Control P and select one more image. Then just select it. Keep it in front. Select both these things and right click, make clipping mask. Okay, so something like this, you can try. Okay. So grid is used for alignments. Okay, if you want to do perfect alignments, we can use the grid. So what is another thing? See, we'll do one interesting example with grid, using grid. Okay, so what you'll do is, see, first we'll activate the grid. Just simply say snap to grid and show grid. Okay, see, make sure that both these options are on. You can also select snap to pixels and snap to point. See, snap to pixel, snap to point, snap to grid. You have to turn on these options, because with these options you can actually do proper alignments. Means the whatever objects you take, they will be properly, see, they can actually sit properly. See, like a magnet, it is sticking to the borders. Okay, so what he'll do is, I will select one pen tool. Okay, so what I will do is, I will first turn off this fill. Okay, only put the stroke. Just to click here, okay. See, click on this line. Okay, click on this line and just drag a point downwards. Okay, then come and just click one more point. Okay, just move this and click one more point over here. Okay, so the point should snap exactly to that grid line. Okay, and then again just drag the point downwards like this, so that you are going to get some curvature. So you should get a curve like this, and hit enter. Okay, see, like this. So it should look something like this. Okay, so it should look something like this. And then the next thing we will do is, again we'll take one more duplicate, alt, and simply drag. If you use alt and drag, you are going to get one duplicate like this. Then what you'll do, so we are going to combine, we are going to create a common shape. So how to create a common shape? Just select the direct selection tool, draw a selection from outside like this. right click, join. Okay, again just draw a selection from outside, right click, join. So we have to create something like this. Okay, and then what is the next step? See, we'll apply some color to this, see, like this, and we'll turn off the stroke. So then again we'll take one more duplicate, okay, and then again we'll just right click, transform and reflect. Okay, so what is reflect? So if you do reflect, it will flip. Okay, it will flip, actually flip upside down. Just click OK. You can adjust it properly. Okay, so then we'll give some different color to this. Okay, see, we can create something like a ribbon. Okay, so something like this, see, and then we'll take one more duplicate. Keep it like this, adjust it, and we will take one more duplicate. Just last one more duplicate we'll create. So we can actually increase the size of our document. Shift O, and then simply increase the size of our document. Okay, then what is the next step we'll do? Alt and drag. Okay, so something like this, see, we have created a ribbon, a ribbon shape we got using the grid. And then what we'll do, we'll just try to increase the size. So just make it like this, and this one we'll select again, keep it like this. Okay, so we have created one small ribbon. Okay, so adjust all these shapes. Then to make it more attractive, so we can give some color to this. Okay, now I will turn off the grid, go to view and select hide grid. So how to apply colors? See, normally we can apply plain colors, but we'll apply gradient colors. But gradient, instead of C, using the gradient, what we'll do is we'll go to windows and swatches. Okay, windows and swatches. So here, see, we have swatches. So what we can do with swatches? See, I can apply this color. Okay, I can apply some ready-made gradients. So some ready-made inbuilt gradients are available to us. So in these swatches, so where we can find the ready-made gradients? You just click on hit this libraries menu, swatches libraries menu, and then here go to gradients, and here we have this gems and jewels. So from gems and jewels, we will select one, some nice interesting gradient. So we'll get some silky gradients. So I will just apply this blue color here. See, so something like this. See. So we can get some nice interesting gradient, see. So something like this, see, some ribbon shape you got, ready made gradients. And then we'll do one thing, so we'll just take one more rectangle like this. Okay, will actually make it go it keep it behind actually. Okay, so we'll just scale it. Okay, so then what I'll do, I'll take one more polygon, so with only three sides, so we'll give some color to this. Okay, we'll rotate it. Okay, we'll make it into a like a pencil. Okay, you can rotate it exactly 90 degrees. How? By holding shift. By holding shift, you can rotate it 90 degrees. Okay, understood? So then I'll just take one more duplicate. We'll give it black color. And we'll make it small. We'll just zoom in and we'll adjust it properly. Okay. Just zoom in. So you can actually select so adjust it properly. Okay, so it's like a nib. So we'll just remove this snap to pixels. We'll just keep snap to point. Okay, and then we'll try to adjust it. Okay, you will understand. So adjust it properly. Okay, check both the sides here. Right, so once we have adjusted it like this, see, you can check the shape here. See, so what we'll do is, see, we can actually group it and make it small like this. Understood? Okay, then what is the next step? So we'll just take one more duplicate here and we will flip it. So again, we'll just say reflect, keep it like this. See, I have created one ribbon using the grid. Okay, then we can duplicate this, can group it. We'll just take a duplicate and then we'll flip it. Okay, something like this. See, able to understand? So we can create some fancy things like this. Okay, okay, and the bottom pencils are there, we can make them as a reflections. So how to make them as reflections? So we'll just take one rectangle. Okay, just keep it like this. Okay, and then see, I'm going to make a fade out. I think I told you in the previous class. What I will do, I'm going to apply a gradient to this. We'll apply a black and white gradient. So we'll use it as a mask. Okay, so we can use it as a mask. See, simply I applied black and white, hit G on the keyboard so that you can see one annotator. So we'll actually rotate it like this. So because we want the black color at the bottom, okay, white color in the beginning, okay, something like this. So it should look something like this. Okay, so then just draw a selection from outside like this, and then what you'll do now, we'll just make it as a mask. So simply click here, opacity, and I think you remember this, make opacity mask. Okay, see, and then we'll just reduce its opacity like this so that it looks like some reflection. Okay, able to understand? Okay, now what is the next step we'll do? So I will actually create one background. So you can create some background here. So we will use some orange background, and we will just select the this annotator. Okay, and then we will keep it behind. See, like this. Okay, we can make it more attractive by giving some drop shadow to this. So drop shadow, see, we'll just give some 20 here, so it should have a very light drop shadow, see. Okay, and we can also give some white color outline if you want, a very light white color outline. See, you got a outline, and it should be very thin. So a very thin white outline. So now it looks attractive. See, we have created some pencil ribbon. Understood? So we can, then we can actually just give some label to this. So we will use one. So we will use this color, white color, or you can use some. Okay, blue color is better, and we can give some white color outline to this. If you want, you can give. Okay. See, we have done this completely using grid, and then we can export it now. So file, export, and we'll export as. So we'll export one as a SVG, another as JPG, or you can say PNG also. So we'll say pencil ribbon. Okay, simply click OK. So see here, we got a pencil ribbon. So we got a very crystal clear files. Okay, and we will also export one in JPEG. So we can just simply click on export. Okay. Oh, sorry. I think wait a minute. So here it is JPG, okay? So I'm exporting it as a JPG. So this is JPG. Comparatively, JPG is little bit light. Okay, JPG is not as clear as SVG. Okay, you can do comparison. Okay, see, SVG is very clear. Yeah, JPG. See, JPG is a little bit dim. Okay, SVG is clear. Okay, so you can export it in SVG actually. Okay. Try to import it in Photoshop and then you can save it as a JPEG. Okay.